ATMOS, a German company with global ambitions, is pioneering affordable re-entry technology to safely return cargo from space. Currently, scientific experiments are included in the cargo of crew vehicles heading back to Earth from ISS. The Cargo Dragon spacecraft also plays a crucial role by returning experiments from the ISS. However, proposing and getting a science experiment approved for the ISS is a lengthy process, often taking months or even years. Experimental slots are constrained by crew availability, resupply schedules, and space on the ISS, which can delay projects significantly. In practice, simple experiments might take 1 to 2 years to be launched on the ISS. On the other hand, more complicated experiments, or those with safety concerns, such as fire or dangerous chemicals, could take 4 to 5 years. Commercially, Varda Space is making progress in space manufacturing with its capsules designed for re-entry and landing. Their first mission has flown and their second re-entry capsule has been built and should be flying early next year. ATMOS aims to offer a simpler, more cost-effective solution, allowing space cargo to return to Earth. They are specifically targeting life sciences, planning for regular flights with short lead times. ATMOS has collaborated with various partners to provide a comprehensive service, which will be covered later in the video. Now let's look at the technology ATMOS is creating. ATMOS's technology enables return of payloads weighing up to 100 kilos. The flight duration is customizable, offering up to 3 months in orbit. And there's flexibility for late sample loading. Throughout the mission, ATMOS allows for real-time monitoring of experiments. The standard power supply is set at 100 watts, but for experiments needing more power, ATMOS offers custom solutions upon request. ATMOS supports various payload formats familiar to scientists, including the ISS mid-deck locker and CubeSat formats like 1U, 2U and 3U. Other formats can be accommodated upon request. For experiments requiring specific conditions, ATMOS supports both pressurized and vacuum environments. In pressurized setups, the temperature can be adjusted within a range from 20 to 37 degrees Celsius. ATMOS offers a comprehensive round-trip service. This service includes picking up experiments from an airport, integrating them at the launch site, and after retrieval, delivering them back to the customer at a designated location, like an airport, ensuring a seamless end-to-end process. This raises the question, how exactly does ATMOS plan to execute the return of cargo from space? ATMOS's solution for returning cargo from space involves the Inflatable Atmospheric Decelerator, or IAD for short. Experiments can be returned that range from a shoebox size up to the size of the largest rocket stages. The IAD serves two main functions. Firstly, it slows down the cargo by providing a large surface area that creates friction as it enters the atmosphere. Secondly, it acts as a heat shield, protecting the valuable cargo from the extreme temperatures encountered during re-entry. Being non-propulsive, the IAD is low in mass. It's simple in design, which reduces the likelihood of failure, and it's also low cost. Its lightweight nature also allows for the recovery and reuse of entire micro-launchers. Interestingly, IADs can be retrofitted to various rocket stages, space modules, or satellites. The material of the IAD is lightweight, durable, and heat-resistant. The heat shield, made from ceramic matrix composite material, is reusable and cools down through radiative means. The IAD is capable of decelerating a payload by 7,800 meters per second, that's orbital speed, all the way down to zero, or very close to zero, for a soft landing back on Earth. Let's go over some of the key milestones for ATMOS so far. In February 2022, they had a successful heat shield test. In order to keep your return vehicle at safe temperatures, you need a heat shield. The classic approach is to have a heat shield for the initial atmospheric re-entry, followed by some small drogue chutes, and finally large parachutes for landing. The ATMOS Inflatable Atmospheric Decelerator needs to be foldable as it is stowed away in orbit and inflated only when the payload needs to return to Earth. The IAD material must be able to withstand temperatures of more than 1000 degrees Celsius and be capable of being inflated without breaking or flaking. ATMOS has a unique way of acquiring the gas they need to inflate the IAD. They will take it from the atmosphere. They have an innovative and patent-pending approach to do this. This has never been done before, so it's intriguing for sure. The company uses a plasma wind tunnel at the Institute for Space Systems in Stuttgart to test their IID. In addition to testing the heat shield materials can withstand the heat, they also demonstrated for the first time they can take air from the hot boundary layer behind the bow shock wave to inflate the IID. The air inlet and flap made from ceramic matrix composites endure glowing hot temperatures and prove their reusability. In June 2023, ATMOS raises €4 million for its breakthrough return capsules that safely deliver any cargo from Earth's orbit. The ATMOS seed funding round was oversubscribed and closed at €4 million. A number of leading space tech investors took part in the seeding round. The €4 million in seed funding now enables ATMOS to carry out its first demonstration flight, probably in 2025. During this milestone flight, it will return a microgravity experiment from low Earth orbit. Maureen Haverty, Vice President at Seraphim Space, said, "We've heard time and time again that the real bottleneck in space life sciences R&D is the time taken to launch and return from the ISS, which makes research far too slow. ATMOS free flyer and return will solve this, eventually scaling to frequent and flexible return from space." Raphael Rottengen, Managing Director at E2MC, said, "Manufacturing in space, especially for life sciences, has significant economic and positive impact potential. The ATMOS team and its unique technology have everything to make regular commercial in-space manufacturing and Earth return a reality. We are excited to help them make it happen." In August 2023, ATMOS explores for re-entry sites. The ATMOS CEO, Sebastian Klaus, has been prospecting possible re-entry sites. He has travelled 1,400 kilometres west of Lisbon to Santa Maria in the Azores archipelago to explore a possible re-entry landing site for the space capsule in the Atlantic Ocean. The island of Santa Maria provides ideal conditions ranging from air control for tracking and logistic infrastructure to airplane and navy support, all of which contributes to the safety of our mission. In October 2023, ATMOS partners with Yuri and RFA. Three German new space companies launched EVA, the world's first end-to-end microgravity service for biotech research and product development. The launch provider is Rocket Factory Augsburg, commonly referred to as RFA for short. ATMOS will provide the return space capsule for any scientific payload, experiment or equipment. And Yuri will provide the modular bioreactors and incubators that can be used for microgravity experiments to develop and manufacture biotech products in space. The partners are hoping that the microgravity service will be available sometime in 2025. This depends on progress in developing the RFA-1 launch vehicle. For more on RFA, please check out my video on them. The life science industry demand for in-space manufacturing is expected to be worth €7 billion in 2030. This new service will be a flexible alternative to the International Space Station and will provide an easier way for scientists to fly their experiments in space. RFA, the launch provider, will launch the ATMOS Space Cargo's Phoenix capsule with Yuri's space taxi payloads on board. RFA will be responsible for the integration of the Phoenix space capsule onto its RFA-1 launch vehicle, while also supporting late loading of payload. The launch campaigns are to be carried out from Saxeford Spaceport, the most northerly of the Shetland Islands in Scotland, UK. Yuri operates a science taxi, a life science incubator and bioreactor. Yuri will be responsible for the execution of biotech research and manufacturing in space. ATMOS Space Cargo is responsible for the re-entry logistics and operating the return mission of the Phoenix return capsule, which will be carrying Yuri's space taxi. ATMOS will supervise and execute the safe return from low Earth orbit to the Azores and carry out the early retrieval of the capsule after landing, as well as the recovery mission to the final location. With EVA, we will set up a unique global service that will allow breakthrough insights in biotech and product development. Customers receive a complete solution from three experts in their respective fields, allowing them to focus on their core business. We are also particularly proud to be able to fully map the value chain with our partners in Germany, This is a great sign of German new space industry capability. In June 2023, the first drop of the inflatable atmospheric decelerator test prototype was conducted near Karlsruhe Baden-Baden Airport. Engineers dropped a third-generation prototype from a helicopter at an altitude of 600 meters. This prototype, attached to a 1-10 scale model of a small launcher's first stage, was designed to inflate reliably and withstand structural stresses upon landing. Upon activation, the IAD successfully stabilized the tumbling rocket stage, slowing it down for a gentle water landing. Unlike conventional parachutes, this IAD design also shields the rocket's delicate engines from the corrosive effects of salt water. ATMOS's use of electric ducted fans for inflation marks a departure from traditional methods, which rely on gas stored in heavy pressure vessels. This approach not only reduces the overall mass, crucial for space applications, but also introduces new challenges, particularly concerning material resilience against the extreme temperatures of atmospheric re-entry. The next phase in the development will focus on testing materials and air inlets that can handle these high temperatures. Both the rocket stage model and the IAD were retrieved successfully after the test, marking a promising step forward in recovery technology for space vehicles. In February 2024, ATMOS joins the European group aiming to develop an inflatable heat shield. ATMOS Space Cargo joined a European consortium named Icarus, aiming to develop an inflatable heat shield for recovering rocket stages from space. The Icarus project, which stands for Inflatable Concept Aeroshell for the recovery of a reusable launcher stage, has received a total of €15 million worth of EU funding. The project's timeline is set out for 4 years, with a demonstration test expected in 2028. Sebastian Klaus, the CEO of ATMOS Space Cargo, said, "Inflatable atmospheric decelerators are at the cutting edge of re-entry technology, and ATMOS Space Cargo has been trusted by consortium partners to design and manufacture the inflatable structure. Icarus aims to become the first flight demonstration of this new technology for the European Union." This project is split into three phases. The first phase is to design the mission. The second is a test flight using a 3-meter inflatable heat shield. And the third phase is a post-flight analysis. In February 2024, ATMOS received an additional $1.3 million in funding from OTB Ventures that joined a group of space tech investors that had previously invested in ATMOS. A partner at OTB Ventures, the new investor, said, "As part of our in-space economy strategy, we have been thoroughly analysing future enabling platforms which decisively shape and grow this emerging sector. ATMOS Space Cargo struck us as one of the most compelling and innovative new companies in a market ripe for dynamic growth. This technology, through a unique combination of cost, frequency and flexibility, intends to close the loop for commercially viable access to space-based R&D and manufacturing, with the ability to spur a new wave of innovation in pharma, semiconductors, material science and other areas." In December 2024, ATMOS and Space Cargo Unlimited signed 7-mission deal. At the New Space Europe conference in Luxembourg, ATMOS announced they are teaming up with France's Space Cargo Unlimited, or SCU for short, to fly 7 orbital research missions. SCU is a customer-facing integrator of novel science experiments, while ATMOS will handle the capsule and inflatable re-entry technology. The two companies are planning on offering a full end-to-end service for customers that need to carry out microgravity experiments in low Earth orbit, promising to fly often and much more cheaply than going to the International Space Station. The first mission planned will spend 2 weeks at an altitude of 500 kilometers and is scheduled for late 2025 on a Falcon 9 rideshare mission. Customers have already booked 80% of the available space, according to the CEO of SCU, Nicolas Gaume. The second mission is 50% full and the third mission is 40% full. ATMOS CEO Sebastian Klaus said, "We are a logistics provider for bio or for semiconductors, for agriculture, or even if it's defense applications. We specialize in bringing cargo back from space. SCU's key product is its bento box, an in-space testing and manufacturing platform that the company developed after flying several research missions to the ISS and on Blue Origin's New Shepard. The firm's first research mission included a round trip to orbit for several bottles of expensive wine. "We bootstrapped this company with space wine," Gaum said. "Now, ATMOS is really unleashing our company to fly these factories." Upcoming events. While ATMOS has stated in the past they are looking to fly their first demonstration flight in 2024, it now looks more likely it will fly sometime in 2025. It's worth noting that the launch provider for ATMOS, at least for the EVA microgravity service, is RFA, which recently experienced a setback when they lost a test vehicle during testing at Saxeford spaceport. This incident might delay the launch schedule, but we will just have to wait and see. For those interested in RFA, I recommend checking out the two videos on this channel. One video gives an overview of the entire company, while the other focuses specifically on their Argo cargo vehicle. Okay, that's it for this video. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.